One of my absolute major passions and one of the major points that's helped me get through life has been my motorcycle. I've got my big black motorbike jacket on and my boots. I found a way to put a wall up from people out there that had, you know, that I'd got bullied. I found this wall, you can't come in and hurt me anymore.
I was watching Connie do girl play. She had the Barbies and she was making a story with them. And she set up a pool and then she put them all in the pool around it in a position so they were ready to talk. And then she went and left the game. And I came up to her and I said, oh, what are they doing? Are they talking to each other? And she said, no, they're in the pool. And it suddenly struck me that although she looked like she was doing imaginative play, that it stopped at the very surface of it. It was a veneer.
Some of the coping mechanisms for me to fit in is quite often this masking thing and pretending to be somebody else, this chameleon factor. Because we want to try and fit in with the group and society in general, so if I'm with a bright and bubbly person, I will try to be funny. The more information we have, the more we can change with our surroundings with us, the more we tend to get accepted because we know something to communicate with someone else.
She looks like she's managing and she looks happy and social, but it's all on the surface. You scratch it, the veneer, it's based on mimicry, and that's the thing that distinguishes the girls from the boys. She fitted every category, there was no doubt about it. It wasn't a slim margin or anything. She was full on, had Asperger's, which is now called ASD2.
Yeah, I remember that conversation. I don't really mind. At first I did think, I'm different and this is bad. But after a little while I realised that I'm same as everybody. I just act a different way and it's fine that I'm different.
Some common traits of females with autism spectrum disorder are similar difficulties to how the males present. They have difficulties in social interaction, yet it is much more subtle.
Hi Connie, hi Anna, come on in.
Hi. Hello.
Due to the way that the female brain is wired, they naturally have a little bit more of the connection socially and emotionally. They're much better at masking their difficulties, so they blend in.
So do you have lots of boy and girlfriends?
Mostly boys.
Why do you think that is?
Because I'm a tomboy and all my life I've just played with boys, and at my school there's more boys than girls. Yeah. And there's only, wait, how many girls are there? It's only four girls.
Why is there only four girls at your school?
Because it's a school that helps with Aspies and people with ADHD and things like that, and there's not many girls with it.
I'm going to write pasta.
Pasta, good. In terms of the proportion of females to males with an autism spectrum disorder, if you're knowledgeable and experienced with the females on the spectrum and you know what to look for, it would almost be one-to-one.
Myself as a child, I was very, very quiet girl. Even in crowds of friends and stuff like that, I could never get it right. You know, when do you speak in the conversation? It's like, okay, I'm just going to keep quiet and try and watch and work this out. I will work this out. For me, seeking a diagnosis only came about after being with my partner Paul and seeing this quirkiness and differences in Paul.
My diagnosis was fairly quick. I got in 2 weeks and it was just like that.
But going through being a woman as well, we don't tend to stand out. And trying to explain, you have these difficulties, you go through these different points, but because you can sit there and talk and present, only after like 40 odd years of trying to get to that point, which is still extremely difficult, they tend not to accept that. And I ended up getting misdiagnosed as bipolar disorder.
I know it was pretty hard on her getting this other diagnosis of the bipolar. I think it was too much information she gave, and it seemed like she was a bit erratic. And where she's been the chameleon and adapted and changed, this has gone against her in that diagnosis.
Females will often be misdiagnosed when they go to see a professional who doesn't have experience with females on the spectrum. So common misdiagnoses are borderline personality disorder. There might even be bipolar there due to the difficulties in regulating their emotions. Quite often, anxiety and depression, yet that might be a co-occurring issue.
Growing up with my mother, Marina, she found it very difficult to socialise with people, was very quiet. This difficulty in connecting to people was something that was actually quite detrimental to her as well. She had this massive meltdown, and the next thing I see her strapped in this bed chair thing, being dragged down the stairs and being put into an ambulance and just watched her go. Once Mum was taken to the institutions and assessed by the psychiatrists that were there, her diagnosis was manic depression, schizophrenia and paranoia. And it was horrible to go back and visit her after that, because she wasn't there anymore. She was no longer my mother. They'd taken away someone that was so very important to me by this whole misunderstanding, and quite simply, she was autistic.
As the awareness of autism spectrum disorder is developing, more and more adult women are ringing up to make referrals. And quite often it is after one of their children has been diagnosed and said, yes, this is me, this explains some of my difficulties. I really want to understand myself better.
I'll get you to make the crepes.
Okie dokie.
Okay.
But I started to realise that there was a reason for how I had felt growing up. I had always felt like someone hadn't told me the rules. I've accepted, and I'm really happy, I'm quite comfortable with accepting that I think I'm on the spectrum as well. I think I have ASD too. I accept myself very differently now. I'm much kinder to myself. And I no longer have that sneaking thought in the back of my head that I'm a failure. I think it's changed my life for the better immensely. It also makes me a much better mother.
If they had the tools for women and diagnostic procedures as they do now, back in the days of my mother, I think my mother would have had a far more fulfilling and accepting life as well.
My life would have been different if my parents had been diagnosed, let alone me. I look at Connie and I wonder about her future. If you find someone who loves you and accepts you, and you love and accept them, to me that's a good life.
I finally got my diagnosis of Asperger's syndrome at the age of 40. For me, it was life began at 40. It seems like a lifetime of difficulties and heartache to finally have this clarification and validation. I can be quirky, I can be different, and I can stop trying so damn hard to fit in.